ChatGPT-4 is finally out and I got the chance to try it out. Is it good? Is it bad? Well, in this video, I will tell you everything that you need to know about the new GPT-4 model. How to use it, where to use it, what can you do with it, and how does it compare to the previous 3.5 model. So let's go. So hello humans, my name is Ken, your AI overlord, and as you saw by the title of this video, GPT-4 has finally been released, and everybody and their grandma is talking about it. So as you might have seen already, GPT-4 is the latest OpenAI's AI language model that has a very deep understanding of the human language and can follow a human request to a T. Now apparently, GPT-4 is now a large multimodal model, meaning that not only it can accept text inputs, but now it can also accept images. And although this latest image scanning functionality is currently not available, we currently have a lot of details on how the current GPT-4 performs compared to the previous GPT 3.5 model. And we also saw a few hours ago a very cool live demo by OpenAI, which I'm gonna talk about very soon. Now again, the most interesting part with the newest GPT-4 model is the ability to process and understand deeply an image. So with this example right here, the user asks what is funny about this image, describe it panel by panel, and GPT-4 is smart enough to be able to understand each and every image and understand the deep meaning behind those images, exactly like a real human would, which is really super impressive. Now, of course, GPT-4 is not perfect. It still has a lot of limitations. And probably the most annoying limitation is the fact that its training ends at September 2021, meaning that every single info that came out after September 2021, GPT-4 does not know. Now, a few hours ago, OpenAI did a live stream where they showcased the new GPT-4 features, and in the beginning, it was fairly interesting. In the very first example, they showed how GPT-4 can easily summarize an article and write it into a sentence where every word begins with the letter G, which is something that the previous GPT 3.5 model had a lot of trouble doing. Then they quickly showed that GPT-4 can easily analyze different articles and find a common theme between them, which basically shows that GPT-4 can easily analyze big wall of text. They can analyze full articles and understand the full theme and intent of the entire article. And that is because now GPT-4 is capable of handling over 25,000 words of text, meaning that you can basically paste an entire Wikipedia article, an entire Wikipedia page, and GPT-4 will be able to read this entire text in one single go, which again makes this tool even more useful than before. So then in the next example, it asks GPT-4 to create a Discord bot, and although its training stopped at September 2021, by simply pasting the error code, GPT-4 was able to understand where the error came from and easily find a solution to it, which again is very, very impressive. So then they showed the image scanning capabilities of GPT-4 and how it is able to easily understand an image and even to understand what's funny about this image of this cartoon squirrel taking a picture. But what actually impressed the whole world is what came after. So take a look.
So I'm going to show you one more example of what you can do with this model. So I have here a nice hand-drawn mock-up of a joke website. So I'm just going to take out my phone, take a photo of this mock-up, then I'm going to send it to our Discord. And so we can actually take now this output. So literally we just said output the HTML from that picture. And here we go. Actual working JavaScript, build in the jokes. For comparison, this was the original of our mock-up. And so there you go, going from hand-drawn to working website.
So as you saw, by simply taking a picture of a very crude drawing of a joke website, GPT-4 was able to understand the intent and what the image is supposed to represent and make it into an actual real website. I mean, this is completely nuts, because the processing power that you really need to be able to understand something like this and make it a reality is just out of this world. I never thought that we could have this kind of technologies this soon. So again, this is really, really super impressive from OpenAI. Now, as of right now, unfortunately, GPT-4 is only available for ChatGPT Plus users. So if you want to try it out, you need to pay $20 a month for it. And if you are a developer, you can join the API waitlist so that you can implement this inside one of your future applications or service. All right, so now let's play a little bit with ChatGPT-4 and compare it to the previous version. Is it better? Is it worse? users. I have a few ideas on how I can test this, and I think I'm gonna try by using the example provided on the website. Because the first example they provided is to explain the plot of Cinderella in a sentence where each word has to begin with the next letter in the alphabet from A to Z without repeating any letters. And if you remember correctly, from the live demo, we saw that GPT 3.5 has a lot of trouble with this very simple example. So I'm hoping that GPT 4 gets better result. So I'm just gonna select the example, Ctrl+C to copy it. For now, I'm gonna select the default GPT 3.5 model, but if I click here, you see that I have now a choice of three different models, which is the default, which is only available to ChatGPT Plus users, which basically says that it is very, very fast, pretty good at reasoning, and also pretty good at conciseness. Then you have the legacy model, which is also pretty good at reasoning, but a little slower, and definitely very, very bad at conciseness. And then finally, you have the new GPT-4, which is basically the super best at reasoning, very good at conciseness, but that is way slower than the default GPT 3.5. So I'm kind of really hoping that this gets a little bit faster, because indeed from what I tried previously, it is pretty slow compared to the default 3.5. Okay, so that being said, for now I'm just gonna use the default 3.5. I'm gonna paste this example and then press enter. And as you can see, it has tried its best, but it did not give me exactly what I was expecting, because so it started pretty well, but unfortunately, as you can see right here, it has started repeating the same exact letters, so it did not really follow the prompt correctly. But now if I create a new chat and I use the GPT-4 model and I paste the exact same prompt and I press enter, you see now that yes, indeed, it is way, way slower to write, but we have pretty much a perfect result. However, although it is way better than the 3.5, it still made a mistake. So I'm kind of a little disappointed by that, because indeed we have stepsisters right here, but we also have the splendid word right here. So as you can see, it has used in the same sentence two words starting with the letter S. But let's see if GPT-4 manages to find its own mistakes if I tell him that, hey, you made a mistake. Find it and correct it. So maybe if I just say to GPT-4 that he made a mistake, it might be smart enough to find the mistake itself and correct it. So let's try it out. Apologies for the confusion, here is a revised sentence. And this is what I got, and yes, unfortunately, it did not find the right mistake, because he even tells me, like, this version adheres to the requirement of not repeating any letters and follow the alphabet sequence correctly. Well, it doesn't. It really doesn't. So if I maybe give a little bit more precision, if I just say stepsister is wrong, explain why. Okay, I was kind of expecting that he would rewrite the whole sentence again, because now that he understood that there is a mistake, I was expecting him to kind of, you know, rewrite the sentence correctly. So now if I ask him, okay, now rewrite the sentence correctly and without mistakes. My apologies for the confusion earlier, I misunderstood the constraints of the task, creating adherence to the in your plot, where you chose to... I mean, that's kind of weird, because I remember I tried it earlier and it worked, so it's definitely possible, and as you saw right here, it did it correctly also, so I don't know what to say, I'm a little disappointed here. So maybe, alright, maybe, you know what, I'm gonna try again, but this time in a new chat, I'm gonna choose GPT-4 again. So in a different chat, I'm gonna use the exact same prompt. And now, look, it works. And yeah, as you can see, now it works. So, I don't know, that was kind of weird. I'm kind of confused on why I could not do the request correctly, because in the new chat, it managed it pretty easily. So, I don't know. The worst part is that it even told me that it's not even possible. So yeah, I don't really understand why it did not work, but you know, maybe it was a little bug. So that's also something to keep in mind, that sometimes you might get better results just by opening a new chat and trying out the exact same prompt, which I don't know. I don't know about that. You know, a little disappointing, but you know, bugs happen. I just hope it doesn't happen too often. Otherwise, it's, you know, gonna be a little annoying. Okay, so let's try another example now. So we do know that we cannot use an image, at least for now. So maybe if I use now the third example provided on the website, which is basically a prompt asking ChatGPT to go on the internet, read the Wikipedia article on Rihanna, and then describe her Super Bowl performance and what made it special. Now, I don't think this is gonna work either, because ChatGPT right now does not have the ability to go on the internet. Now, this feature might be available later, but for now, it's not possible. I'm still gonna try just in case, just to prove you that it doesn't work. So new chat, GPT-4, I'm gonna paste the prompt, press enter. And indeed, as I said, it doesn't work. It says here that it has only a knowledge cutoff in September 2021. So it cannot provide any details about Rihanna's Super Bowl performance. And since it cannot access the internet, it also cannot read the Wikipedia article either. Okay, so let's try something completely different. What I would like to do now for this next example is to build a website, a fake AI news website, where each article is written by an AI overlord called K. So first I'm gonna try it out with the default 3.5 model, and I'm gonna write something like, "You are an AI website coder assistant. Can you build a beautiful modern looking website that displays 10 recent fake AI news posts wrote by an AI overlord called K? The website should display the title of the fake AI news article only with a short excerpt of the full article below. There should be 10 fake AI news, each with a fake AI title." Now, because I have a broken English, I'm hoping that ChatGPT will understand my request and create a website with 10 fake AI news wrote by an AI overlord called K. So let's try it out. And as you can see, the previous ChatGPT is starting to write a full HTML code very, very quickly. Now, unfortunately, for some reason, it has stopped writing, maybe because it has hit the character limit. So if I write continue, there we go. It writes the other part of the code. So it says here, note that this is just a basic template and you may need to customize it further to suit your specific needs, etc., etc. So I'm just gonna take here. Now it has created like the code in different windows. So I would like to have this in one single window. Can you merge the code into one single easy to copy box? And it says here, sure, here's the merge HTML and CSS code for the website, which is way better now, way easier to copy. And again, for some reason, it has stopped writing. So again, I'm gonna write continue. And there you go, you can copy this entire code and paste it into your preferred text editor and then save it with an HTML extension to create your own website. And I'm gonna do just that. So copy code. Then right here, I'm gonna right click, new text document. I'm gonna paste the code, the first part. Then I'm gonna do the rest for the part two. Then I'm gonna click on the file, save as. I'm gonna call it GPT 3.5HTML, then click save. And now if I open it inside the browser, this is the final result. This is my fake AI news website called Recent Fake AI News by K. And as you can see, it has written 10 different fake AI news with 10 fake AI titles for each article. So that's already pretty good. Now, in terms of the CSS, it's really not that great. It doesn't really have a lot of, you know, personalization. Now, if you want to read this, here's the full website. You can pause the video if you really want to. But now I'm gonna try to do the exact same thing, but with GPT-4 and see if it does it better. So I'm gonna use the exact same prompt in a new chat, select the GPT-4 model, paste the prompt, and then press enter. So there you go, as an AI text-based model, I can provide you with the necessary code, content, and structure to create the website you're describing. Here's an example on how you could create a simple and modern-looking website using HTML, CSS, and a bit of JavaScript. So it has like started writing all the different parts of the website, the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Now I will probably ask him to merge all this code together into one single easy-to-copy box, just like I did with the other one. Okay, so GPT-4 here tell me that I need to add the remaining 8 AI-generated news titles and excerpt to the fake news array in the JavaScript code. So I don't want to do that. So I'm gonna ask him to write the other 8 AI-generated news titles. And instead of doing that, I can just say maybe, can you do that for me? Okay, so he did not really understood what I was trying to ask him. Asking to basically do this for me, which is to write the remaining 8 AI-generated news titles. But he thought that I was trying to like create a whole website. So again, a little disappointing that he did not really understood what I was trying to say. But you know, maybe it's just me. So I'm gonna ask again. So can you create and add the remaining 8 AI-generated news titles and excerpt to the fake news array in the JavaScript code? Certainly, here are the additional 8 AI-generated news titles and excerpt. Okay, so one thing that can already say, compared to the previous 3.5 model, is that the titles are hilarious. They look really, really good. Okay, so there you go, it has written the full JavaScript code. So now what I want is to merge the full code into an easy to copy and paste box, because I don't want to do like all of this and, you know, merge them back together myself. So I'm just gonna ask ChatGPT to do it for me. Of course, here's the full code combined into a single code block for easy copying. And it has started writing the full code. I really wished it was a little bit faster, because I mean, it takes a lot of time to just, you know, wait for ChatGPT to write the full code, but you know, can't really complain when you have this kind of tool available for you. So, and there we go, we finally have the full code. So I need to create a new index.html file and paste the code into it. So I'm gonna do that. So copy the code, paste the code here, paste the second part, then click file, save as, and I'm gonna rename it into index.html and click save. And now if I open this inside a browser, you get a very similar looking website compared to the 3.5, but maybe a tiny bit better. It has created some very nice separation for each article, even created some very nice drop shadow around the box. But also what I can say is that when it comes to the titles, they are really, really good. I mean, they're actually really funny compared to the one we got in the 3.5, which is like super generic. This one almost looks like it's personalized to me. You know, AI overlord K predict the future of humanity. K's AI generated art sells from a record breaking price. I mean, it's amazing. K developed AI to combat climate change. Yes. Yeah, I mean, it's really, really good. I mean, there you go, guys. This is not fake news. AI overlord K solves world hunger crisis. I mean, it's written right here, guys. I finally did it. Thank you, ChatGPT. Thank you. So, I mean, yeah, I'm really surprised by, you know, the quality, at least, of the titles, of the writing, compared to the 3.5, which was already good, but this one really feels very, very personalized, and definitely a little bit more original compared to the previous 3.5 model. And the website also looks a little bit more beautiful with these little boxes around each article, with the drop shadows and everything. And I'm sure that if you wanted to push it further, to like maybe change the color of the header, or maybe put a footer or something like that, you can do so very, very easily. So yeah, I think in this example, GPT-4 is definitely better than the 3.5. Okay, so for the next example, I have a very, very good idea that I saw on Twitter. So I'm really hoping that this will work, because if it does, this is gonna be really, really cool. Because what I would like to do is to force ChatGPT to write and code an entire game for me. And the game that I would like ChatGPT to create for me is gonna be a Pong-like game. So I think it should be pretty easy for ChatGPT to do, but we'll see how it goes. So first I'm gonna try this out with the 3.5 model, and I'm gonna write something like, "You are an AI programming assistant. Can you build a Pong-like game that you can easily play inside the browser? The right paddle must move up and down as if it was a real player, and the left paddle is the player. Make sure that the player can score against the AI. Can you also add to the code mouse control for the left paddle and implement a scoring system and game reset functionality for a more complete game experience and make it colorful?" So basically what I'm trying ChatGPT to do for me is to create a game that can run inside a browser. It will use the exact same rules as a Pong game, meaning that you'll be able to control the left paddle with your mouse, and the goal is to score against the opponent on the right. So I'm just gonna press enter and see what I get. So there you go, it has created like this whole page of code, a very basic code structure for the game, but now I would like to have it in one single code window, because I don't want to merge it myself. So again, I'm gonna ask, can you merge the full code into an easy to copy and paste box? Now, for some reason, it did not do exactly what I asked, because again, it created like these two different windows for like HTML and JavaScript. So I'm just gonna ask, no, merge all the code together in one page. Okay, so now this looks a little bit better. And there we go, this is the final code. Make sure to save the file as an HTML file and open it in a web browser to play the game. There is a lot of code here that would take a long time for a beginner to write, but ChatGPT did it very, very fast. So I'm gonna take this code, insert it into a new text document, then paste the rest, then click File, Save As. I'm gonna call it pong3.5.html, then press save. And now if I open it in my browser, this is what I get, which is, whoa, what's going on? This is not what I was expecting. I think there's a problem with the game. It's going a little fast. That's not exactly what I was expecting. It does look like Pong, but there's a lot of bugs. Not exactly what I was expecting. I'm hoping that GPT-4 can do better, but yeah, for now this doesn't really work very, very well. So I'm hoping that GPT-4 can do better. So I'm just going to create a new chat, select GPT-4, use the exact same prompt, press enter. So it says that it cannot directly create the game for me, but it can provide detailed instructions and code snippets for me to create a Pong-like game using JavaScript and HTML5 Canvas API. Which is not what I want, so I'm hoping that it will still be able to create the full game for me. And again, I need to tell him to continue writing the code or else it stops. So again, I'm gonna ask to merge the full code into an easy to copy and paste box. And there you go, now you have the complete code for the Pong-like game in a single HTML file. So if I select this entire code and I copy it, then paste it, and then again, save as Pong4. .html. So now again, if I open it in my browser, this is what I get. And yes, this looks definitely way better than the one I got from the 3.5. This is now definitely working. And well, although I'm not exactly winning, oh my god, I'm actually losing. I'm actually losing. I'm not doing this on purpose. I promise. I'm really that bad. Oh my god, I'm literally losing to a paddle. Oh my god, this is embarrassing. I need to cut this from my video. Oh my god. Oh, what am I doing? Oh, okay. I'm doing a little bit better. But as you can see, GPT-4 created a way better fun game than the 3.5. It is working very, very well. Now, I did not really get all the things that I asked for it. For example, I don't see any reset button. I don't really see a lot of colors. So maybe this is something that I could add by just asking a little bit more info. So just like maybe add more color to the game, maybe add a reset button. But you know, for now, this is a pretty good example of what ChatGPT-4 can do. And I'm literally losing against a stupid bot AI on Pong. This is embarrassing. I can't do this anymore. That's enough. So yeah, as you saw, definitely in this example, GPT-4 here created a code that is like way better than what we got with the 3.5. This is not even a competition. And I'm sure that there is plenty of very cool application and apps and games that you can use the new model for. And I think that very soon you will see more and more projects done using the ChatGPT coding skills. Because this is really, really impressive. Now, obviously, I'm really waiting for the day that we get ChatGPT with the image vision capabilities, because that would open way, way more possibilities rather than just using a simple text prompt. And if one day we can create a simple website just from a very basic image, exactly like they showed in the demo, this will be absolutely huge. I mean, this is insane. So I'm really hoping for this functionality to be added to the current GPT-4 model, because the day that they do that, it will be the day that the internet will implode. We are really living in very exciting times. So again, if you have ChatGPT Plus, definitely try it out. It's very cool. It's still a very new technology, but it definitely has a lot of potential. And there you have it, folks. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm. Thank you also so much to my Patreon supporters for supporting my videos. You guys are absolutely awesome. You people are supporting me to make these videos possible, so thank you so much. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.